Hi everyone, welcome to the sixth lecture of the series. So in this presentation, I'm again going to demonstrate how to show if an algebraic structure is a semiring. So this time I'll be using the log semiring as an example. So let's get started. Now again, suppose we're given this expression here, right? This five tuple, where k is a set of real numbers from negative infinity to positive infinity. Now the addition operator now is it's a bit funky now. Let's call this the log addition. So the log addition between x and y is given as negative log base e, right? Times so it's e to the power of minus x plus e to the power of minus y, right? So this is the definition of the log addition, right? So later we'll be using this quite a lot, right? And then the rest of the thing is the things are pretty much the same as a tropical semiring, with the multiplication defined as a classical addition, and 0 bar, the additive identity, defined as the positive infinity, and 1 bar defined as a the zero real number, right? So if I were to write this out, so x log addition, right, plus the log addition of y and z, right? You can write this out as this plus this. So you use the definition above, you write this out, you get x plus y plus z, right? And then here you expand it again. You expand using the same definition, right? X plus y, so in this case it's y plus z, is equivalent to negative log of e power minus y plus e power minus z. So from here on, it's just the stuff that you learn in secondary school. Right, so the negative sign will cancel out. You give you this, right? Exponentiating something to the logarithm function, well, it cancels out one another because e and log, they are inverse of each other, right? So e and log, you cancel out, and then you just get whatever the part is in the power. So you get this key step here: e power minus x plus e power minus y plus e power minus z, right? And using the same trick, right, that we see here. We group these two together and raise them e to the power of log e to the power of log, right? And within it is e to the power minus x plus e to the power minus y, right? You can see this, right? So what does this thing stand for? Well, it's the, we know using definition, it's the negative of x plus y, x plus log x log addition y, right? And what is this this final, the second final line here? You can use the same definition here, and then you can rewrite it as x plus y plus z. And I've shown that even though this looks nothing like classical addition, but it behaves in some way similar to a classical addition, as in that it's associative, it's associative for addition, right? So moving on, I need to show two more things, I believe. I need to show commutativity as well as the existence of the additive identity. So for commutativity, it's pretty straightforward. If you write everything out, right, x plus y is equal to this by definition. We can flip this because there's a classical addition here. We can flip this, you get e to the power of minus y plus e to the power of minus x, and by definition it's equals to y plus x, right? So I've shown that it's commutative, right? And then the presence of the additive identity. Well, so x plus 0 bar, right? By definition, it's equal to this, negative log of e power minus x plus e power negative infinity. Now, if you're a mathematician, you'd probably be cringing right now. I won't blame you, but for simplicity's sake, most of us, we remember if e to the power of a really, really negative number, really, really huge negative number, well, this value tends to zero. So if I were to be a bit more rigorous, I have to use limits here. Let's just cut short the steps and just assume that this goes to zero, right? This takes on the value zero. You shouldn't do that, but suppose this takes on zero. So this expression can be reduced to this, right? And I hope we can convince yourself using the secondary school logarithmic algebra that this expression is equal to this expression here, right? So one way to see it is that e power minus x, you can take down the minus x because e is positive. You can take down the minus x. So the negative sign cancels out with the negative sign here. You get x times log e. Well, since log is of base e, log e is 1. So it's 1 times x, you get x. So you can see that x, using this definition of addition, x plus 0 bar well, gives you x, right? I've shown that the additive identity and identity works, right? And it's actually the positive infinity. So the remaining things to show is the properties for the multiplication operator, namely the associativity of the multiplication operator. So again, it's easy to show these two things because I've done it for the previous lecture. And the reason is that these two holds is because classical addition, the properties of classical addition, right? You can look through yourself. And finally, the more interesting part, as well as the slightly more tedious part, would be the distributivity of multiplication. So let's see if I was to start with the left distributivity of multiplication. Well, if I were to write this out neatly, so z times x plus y, well, z times is defined as classical addition. So z plus negative log e power minus x plus e power minus y. Now, because it's a negative, so I just replace the addition with the subtraction here. All right, so I can use the same trick to say that z is equivalent to negative log e power minus z, right? I've just gone through why these two are essentially the same thing. Now, having this, I just, if I do a little bit of algebra by applying some brackets, the negative sign becomes a positive sign, and then therefore I can multiply this with this entire expression, right? So this e power minus x goes into e power minus x, and also goes into e power minus y, right? So you get this expression, right? So you get this expression, and you can add the exponents up together, right? You get this expression here. Now this, by definition, is just this log adding this, right? So you can see that that's how I reach this. This is purely by definition. And again, by definition of this semi-ring, z plus x is actually equals to z times x. Z plus y is equal to z times y. And I've shown that I've left distributed this, right? I've left distributed the multiplication into the brackets. So then the proof of the right distributive property is also similar. The smart way to do this is to notice that the addition, right, the classical addition, which is the multiplication in this semi-ring, is actually commutative, which means you can flip, right? So it becomes this times z, right? You can flip this particular expression, you can flip this two, you can flip this two, because it's commutative. And if you flip the three things, you realize that you have just essentially shown that it's right distributive as well, right? So I've come to the end of the proof of the log semi-ring. And I hope that you understood this. These particular two chapters are more mathematically intensive, I agree. But it serves for a good purpose to help you learn how to prove if whatever algebraic structure you have is indeed a semi-ring. Okay, so if you want more references, again, read these two persons' books, Speech Recognition Algorithms Using Weighted Finite State Transducers by Taka Kihori, and Speech Recognition with Weighted Finite State Transducers by Mori, right? Once again, if you have enjoyed this lecture, I hope to see you again.